in high definition. CBS 3 Eyewitness News.
Another day of emotionally charged testimony in the Jerry Sandusky trial. More alleged victims testified against the former Penn State assistant coach, and so did the father of Mike McQuarrie. Our Ben Simino has been inside the courtroom, and we warn you, details of today's testimony are graphic.
Moving swiftly through their case against Jerry Sandusky, prosecutors called three more of his accusers Wednesday, who all told stories with striking similarities. Alleged victims 7 and 10 told how they would stay at Sandusky's State College home, which is where alleged victim 10 said he was assaulted. "We were wrestling," he said, "and the defendant pinned me to the ground. He pulled my shorts down and started performing oral sex on me." "What did you do?" prosecutor Joe McGinnigan asked. "I freaked out, got nervous and scared." And then he said Sandusky threatened him. Quote, "He told me if I told anybody, I would never see my family again. He apologized for saying that, told me he didn't mean it, and he loved me." Both also told of lewd behavior while Sandusky was driving.
I believe that what you see is a pattern that's inescapable.
Tom Klein represents alleged victim 5, now 23 years old, who in a quiet voice told the court that Jerry Sandusky assaulted him in the showers at Penn State's football building during the summer of 2001 when he was 13. Through tears, he said Sandusky made him inappropriately touch him.
Just remarkable how many young children one man can shower with.
Interestingly, though, that event allegedly happened months after the shower incident involving Mike McQuarrie, which means very little changed at Penn State. McQuarrie is the Penn State football grad assistant who reported to administrators Tim Curley and Gary Schultz that he saw Sandusky rape a boy in Penn State showers. On the witness stand, McQuarrie's father, John, confirmed that his son was clear on what he saw. "Was it a sexual act?" he was asked. "Yes, I think that was my conclusion, yes." But on cross-examination, John McQuarrie's memory seemed questionable. He could not remember testifying at a hearing in Harrisburg just last December. And when John McQuarrie went to Gary Schultz, Penn State vice president who's charged with lying about this case, to follow up what his son had reported, he said that Schultz told him he had already heard noise about Jerry Sandusky's behavior even before Mike McQuarrie reported anything. In Bellefonte Center County, I'm Ben Simino, CBS 3 Eyewitness News.
And stay with Eyewitness News as the testimony continues in the Jerry Sandusky trial. We have updates on TV and online. Just go to cbsphilly.com.